the latest trailer for Avengers Endgame dropping, it's time for me to stop and share my 10 favorite Endgame theories. So let's talk about it. Hi, if you're new here, my name is Sean, and I started this channel because I was spending way too much time in other people's comment sections talking about movies way too much, and I thought, hey, why not start my own channel where I get to drive the conversation? With that in mind, go ahead and join me down below in the comment section. Share your absolute favorite Avengers Endgame theories. Let's have a nice lively discussion talking about this movie that we are all very excited to see. Also, as we go into this, this is a movie channel, not an Avengers theory channel, so I'm sharing my 10 favorite theories that either I've come up with myself or I've heard from other people, but I'm not trying to come up with like 10 theories that no one has ever said before. That's not what my channel's about. Just trying to spark a nice conversation about our favorite and the best Avengers Endgame theories that we've all heard. With that said, let's get started. Theory number one, there is a time jump inside of the movie. So there's been plenty of speculation all along that there's gonna be a time jump between the movies. You see the appearance of age in kind of the look of the city. There's people in support groups. There's talk about moving on. Very clearly, they're establishing an amount of time has passed since Thanos snap. But I think the movie's gonna pick up pretty close to right after Infinity War ends, and then the time jump, the time passes inside of the movie itself, from the beginning of this film to the end of this film, a bunch of time is going to pass. And you see that in several different places. The one that seems most obvious to me is Black Widow's hair. You have shots inside of the trailers as well as the Captain Marvel end scene where Black Widow has the hairstyle that she had in Infinity War. But then you have other shots where she has longer hair, she has it's back red on the top, it's pulled back and it's red, and so you see a bunch of different shots where she has distinctly blonde hair and distinctly longer red hair, which would indicate time is passing. Also, with the way that they've demonstrated that space travel works inside of this universe, it's not like real world space travel. You see people move from place to place pretty quickly. And the idea that Nick Fury sends a message out to Captain Marvel, it seems like she would get back pretty quickly. It wouldn't be years passing, it'd be pretty quick that she would arrive back. And that's what seems to happen based off several other pieces of evidence inside of the film. So as a little extra theory in here, I think that she arrives back within the first 15 minutes of the film. Theory number two, Thor and Captain Marvel go after Thanos pretty early in the movie. Based off the trailers we've seen thus far, we've only seen Captain Marvel basically in the one location, as well as in the post-credit scene, still that one location. We haven't seen her with a bunch of people in a bunch of different places. Likewise with Thor, we've seen shots of him all throughout these trailers, but it's like him in the hoodie looking sad, and then shots of him off in other places by himself. Likewise, we didn't see him in the white suit at the end of this latest trailer. In the set photos that I've seen, we don't see short hair, modern time Thor in the set photos going back to Avengers 1 that I have seen thus far. So I think that very early in this movie, Captain Marvel, Thor, maybe some other people head on out after Thanos to go and try and take him out, and they probably fail miserably. Another little side one here, but potentially Thor dies very early on in the movie, and at this point in time, after they've been sent off, then our time jump occurs inside of the film. All right, the next three theories I'm gonna put out there kind of conflict with each other. They're all Tony Stark ones of different potential directions that I would be interested in them taking Tony Stark in this film. Theory number three, Captain Marvel rescues Tony and Nebula out in space. So this one could go two different ways. Either after she gets her little pager message from Nick Fury, she's flying back to Earth and just by chance happens to stumble across Tony in space, or she gets back to Earth in the first 10-15 minutes and they say, hey, you got to get this guy named Tony Stark, he's awesome, see if you can go and find him. And they don't even know, I guess back on Earth, they wouldn't even know that all those other people along with him got taken out too. So they say, hey, go get Doctor Strange, go get Tony, see who else you can go rescue out there. And she goes out in space to go and rescue them, brings back, and it's Nebula, who they have no clue who that is, and it's Tony, and they're probably disheartened to learn all of those other potential people that could have been with them have died in the process. But this would explain how they get back to Earth, despite the fact that Tony's like, I thought I was gonna pull off something special, and looks like I've failed, we're about to run out of food and water and everything. Now we have an answer how potentially he got back for that final shot to be in the white suit. Theory number four is that Tony is in space for years. He's in there a very long time. This would explain why he just seems so, like, absolutely broken and giving up in these scenes that we've seen throughout the trailers, the tone of where he is at. But where I'm getting this one from is that if you look at the set photos that they've shown of him in Avengers 1, he's got, like, his hair looks lighter to me, grayer to me, more kind of salt inside of the little goatee thing. So it gives off the impression to me that he has been out in space for a long time, potentially based off these set photos. Could be totally wrong, could just be the lighting, but he looks older in those photos versus every other time we've ever seen Tony Stark anywhere else in the MCU. Theory number five is that Tony dies in the first half of the movie, and the Tony that is going to battle in the third act of the film is actually Tony from the past or some other multiverse outside of there. Once again, this theory has two different paths to it. Theory number one, he just dies in space. He's stranded in space too long and starves to death. Maybe Nebula lives because she's cyborg thing. She doesn't have the human requirements that he has. So Tony dies in space. Captain Marvel or whoever rescues Nebula brings Nebula back to Earth. And in their, like, how are we going to beat Thanos? We got to get Tony. So in their time travel, they bring Tony back from the past, or they go to a different realm, different multiverse, grab a Tony, maybe a future Tony or something like that that's older, bring him back, and he battles there. So that's path number one. Tony dies in space in the first half of the movie, and Nebula kind of informs them of something. Maybe Tony learns, I don't know, something like that. Second path it takes, Captain Marvel brings Tony back to Earth, or Pepper flies into space, whatever, however Tony gets rescued, gets back to Earth. Tony goes with Thor, as well as Captain Marvel, to go and battle Thanos in the first half of the movie as their first attempt to go, like, let's rescue, save the day, and take him out and get our own Infinity Gauntlet done, do all this, and he dies. Tony dies in the first half trying to take out Thanos. He's just so enraged, as we've seen him become enraged before over things like this, over Spider-Man dying in his arms, as well as half of everyone else in the universe. And so he goes out for revenge and dies in the process. And this leads them to go even more desperate in their attempts to change things with quantum realm and time travel and things like that. This leads to a very similar theory to this one. Thor dies in the first half of the movie as well. Same exact theory as before. Captain Marvel and Thor go to try and take out Thanos. He's angry. He's so broken. He makes this desperate move to go try and take out Thanos. He gets killed by Thanos in the first half of the movie. And therefore, when they go back in time, one of their strategies in going back in time is we got to get another Thor. We got to get Thor to come and battle him in the present with all of us together with a better plan than let's just jump him. And so they bring him back from the past, from a multiverse or whatever, to the present time to try and battle Thanos. Perhaps just throwing spitballing ideas out here. We see the final shot in this latest trailer. Reaches out his hand next to Captain Marvel. Mjolnir flies in, flies into his hand next to Captain Marvel's head. Her hair kind of blows and he's like, I like this one, because she's unfazed by it. Why does he have that hammer and not Stormbreaker? We'll get into this a little bit later. Some other theories on that one. But potentially, we are looking at Thor from a different point in time, or looking at Thor from a different multiverse or something like that, and that's why we don't see him in some of these other shots in the film or something like that. That is a different Thor. Of course, this theory conflicts with the one that I said at the beginning of this, where I said that Captain Marvel arrives at the beginning, and that shot of the two of them interacting with each other is them from the beginning of the film. Certainly undoes that entire theory, so like I said, there's a lot of conflict inside of my theories. Theory number seven, our Avengers complex gets destroyed. So where this one comes from is there's a shot in the trailer that at first looks like just Ant-Man in the complex, and it's like, oh look, it's Ant-Man. But if you watch it in slow-mo, at the very end of it, orange starts to appear behind him as if the building's being blown up, as if he's watching an explosion taking place. And then throughout this latest trailer, you see kind of three different shots of people in what looks like this desolate place. You got one of Nebula pulling out some knives. You've got Steve looking covered in dust or ash, picking up his shield, looking really intense. And then you have Ant-Man in what looks like an indoor space because he's on a pencil. That's Earth, and he's running on the pencil, and then you see like a quarter inch cable for like, that's a big kind of jack for headphones or like a guitar cable, and he's running, and then there's some water that goes underneath it, so implying he's definitely almost certainly on Earth. Pencil's very earthy technology, and we see him in a space that looks like it's blowing up. Then also in the trailer, we see Steve and Clint out at a lake. Why are they out at a lake? Well, potentially their little base right here got blown up and they need to go hang out somewhere else. Theory number 8, the decimation kills Clint's family. I think that we see this in the first 5 minutes of the movie. That shot inside the trailer of him showing his daughter how to shoot arrows, my speculation is that the rest of that scene is that very early in the movie, he's outside with his daughter, and we see the decimation, and his daughter turns to dust inside of his arms, and we see him kind of convert into Ronin. Sort of along these same lines, I'm guessing the beginning of the movie probably will have some sort of like, we're just going to see the universe from the perspective of all these different people on all the planets that we've been through throughout all of this as just people turn to dust. And this is going to have the most depressing opening to a movie we've ever seen, one of those being Clint's family dying right there in front of him. Real quick, before I give you my final two theories, and my personal favorite one is the next one, be sure to tell me your favorite theories down below in the comment sections. Which are the ones that you absolutely love, that you're the most excited for? Let's have a nice lively discussion about all that fun stuff. Also, after this video, if you want more of my Marvel content, right up here you can see my full breakdown shot by shot of this latest trailer, or you can see my ranking of all 21 MCU films and find out my whole take on the entire universe. Theory number 9, Tony rebuilds Ultron. So there's been tons of speculation about them going back in time to the first Avengers movie. We've seen set photos of what looks like the Battle of New York, as well as Loki being sent back off to Asgard. I think that given the nature of this film, the nature of why Ultron was created, even the marketing of the film showing this montage of all the these different films inside of the MCU up to this point in time, and then even the name Endgame itself, I think there's a lot of hints that Ultron is coming back. In fact, Endgame was used in the movie Age of Ultron to refer to Ultron.
A hostile alien army came charging through a hole in space.
That up there, that's Endgame.
How are you guys planning on beating that?
Thanos is the exact type of threat that led Tony to create Ultron in the first place. His fear of some villain out there that could take out all of his friends, that he wouldn't do enough to be able to save all of his friends. That is why he created Ultron in the first place as the endgame, that he could retire while protecting the Earth. So with some proper programming and a Thanos-sized threat, Ultron suddenly becomes the Earth and the universe's protector. Also, remember, the reason that Tony created Ultron, that kind of drove all of this, is that he was in that, like, fortress, and Scarlet Witch kind of played mind games on him that gave him these visions, and it's all Infinity Stone is where her powers come from. Infinity Stone is what he's reaching for. It's all Infinity Stone type stuff that kind of shapes his mind a little bit, thinking, I need to do more, I need to do more, I need to do whatever I can do. And then he goes off and creates Ultron with an Infinity Stone. It all has these ties back to the powers of Infinity Stones that led to the visions, that led to the creation of Ultron, someone that potentially could have stopped Thanos in the first film had Ultron been in existence and functioning properly. And so there's just a lot of dramatic reasons that I think that if you put Ultron in this movie, you redeem Tony a little bit. Tony is kind of one of the biggest villains inside of the MCU because of Age of Ultron, and that led into Civil War. All these things that kind of happen because of Tony's creation of Ultron that can have like poetic justice inside of this one of like, there's a little bit of redemption inside of that. Ultron himself can have redemption. Ultron wasn't a terrible idea. Ultron was just executed poorly. What if he's executed properly? Likewise, you just kind of give that bookend to all of those visions, all of the stuff that Scarlet Witch put into Tony's head. You can bookend it with this movie, tie off all the loose ends, and kind of resolve it, which is all of the marketing up to this point in time has indicated that's what they're trying to do, is really be like, here is the full MCU up to this point in time. Let's bookend this thing. Let's tie it all back together and do like the coolest thing that's ever been done in movies. I think Ultron would be a big part of it. Theory number 10, the trailers are intentionally edited to mislead us. Now this is where kind of all these theories, it's fun to speculate, but we can kind of take everything we're saying and throw it up in the air. Who knows what inside of this trailer and all these trailers has been digitally edited to intentionally mislead us. Based off what we absolutely know from the Infinity War marketing, they market these films to properly establish the threat, the themes, the general direction of the film, and they are very comfortable changing specific details inside of the trailers so that you can't do what we're doing right now. They're putting false information in their trailers intentionally so we can't figure out what the actual specific plot to this movie is. And you can see that in Infinity War. There's full articles listing off all of the ways in which they intentionally misled the audience going into Infinity War. The most blatant example is the clip that I have at the beginning of all my videos. You see a shot of them in Wakanda that is not in the movie, and Hulk is very prominent right there in the shot. That is blatant deception entirely. They don't mismarket the movies in case they're mis-selling what the movie is generally about. They're intentionally misleading so that you can't do what we're doing right now. And if they would put the Hulk in the Battle of Wakanda, they certainly would edit in Tony and Nebula, or just Tony, into that final shot of them in white suits. They would absolutely edit Scarlett Johansson's hair to change the color, to give it a gradient in certain shots, to make it blonde in certain shots, to change the length of it in certain shots. They would certainly create shots where he puts out his hand and a different hammer arrives in his hand than the one that will actually appear in his hand inside of the movie. If they'll put Hulk in the Battle of Wakanda, all bets are off. So these videos are so much fun to make, to speculate about, but everything that we're saying, you gotta take it, not with a grain of salt, with a whole container of salt, because we have no idea how they're trying to mislead us. I love what they've done thus far. I loved the marketing for Infinity War. I love that they misled me going into Infinity War. I was very happy with that movie. If you've been following my channel any amount of time, you know that. So I'm hoping they're doing the same thing here, and my guesses are totally wrong, because they're smarter than me, and they're gonna deliver something that I absolutely love. Big shout out to Mick, who actually heard several of these theories back in December in a special Christmas present video I did just for him. If you want more of my MCU content, you can see my ranking of the MCU movies right there. You can see my breakdown of the trailer right down there. Thank you so much for watching, and keep talking movies too much.